Well, we've got one more item to look at from the queue of people who've been coming to see us today. But first, let's see how Francis and Hero got on their spree to find the best bargain of the day. Well, Hero, what did you get?
I got this Trainspotting CD, which is a promotional version.
How much for?
£10.
£10. You got another fiver?
Yes.
And what did you get, Francis?
I got an In Excess single. It hasn't been released in the UK, so it seemed quite rare to me. And
how much did you pay?
£15.
Let's show our panel. What do you think of these guys?
Yeah, I've mainly taken John's advice on this, but we have come to a unanimous decision.
Yeah, I mean, the problem with that, it's only got a promotional sticker. It's actually just the normal version. So it's worth £10, very good value.
Beware of the stickers. They could just be put on.
So definitely the In Excess one, I think, would be the winner.
That's the winner?
Yeah,
the In Excess one, so you're the winner. I'm so sorry. And you get a pile of CDs. Oh,
brilliant.
But also, you can get this T-shirt, which is signed by the band Universal. It's a Universal T-shirt, if you answer this simple, trivial question, which is, who or what band or who has played mostly at Wembley more than any other artist or artists?
Michael Jackson.
Well, you're right. Well, thank you so much for coming
along. Thank you very
Congratulations.
Much. Thank you
winner.
Very much. Thank you.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye. Thank you.
Well, we've got enough time just now for one final guest, a Mr. Charlie Ivans, who's brought us an unused invitation from the Michael Jackson launch of Blood on the Dance Floor in London, and also a debut single from Jeans. Hi, Charlie.
Hello.
I understand you work in the industry.
That's right, yes.
And so you get all these things quite easily?
Well, yes, you can normally. In fact, I actually bought the records, but...
Should we ask our panel what they have to say about what you brought
in? Oh, yes, I'd love to know.
Okay. How about you, Ted?
Well, I think this is a nice little collector's bag. We've got the little packaging bag here, which has got the seat layout, the card, the cassette, the introduction, and the presentation ticket, Odeon Leicester Square.
Why is it unused? I should think people were absolutely clamouring for this.
I don't know if it is unused, but is it?
It is unused, it's unclear.
Okay. Makes it even more collectible, really, in many ways, so because it's not been ripped off. Nice piece.
What about the Jean debut?
Yeah, I mean, in terms of like 90s rarities, this is one of the top ones, you know, mega bucks really. 90 Smith's first single for The Dead, the original issue. Limited to 1,994 copies, which was the year of issue, 1994. And the fact that it's signed by all the band as well makes it even more interesting.
Oh, interesting. Well, we'll find a value for these in just a minute. What this is all worth. Charlie, what do you think? What do you think this Michael Jackson stuff is worth?
Well, I'd hazard a guess. I think if you're a nutty Michael Jackson fan, it's probably worth about £40-50.
Really? And the other, the Gene?
The other one, probably 25 or 30. I mean, it only cost me £2, so.
Let's see
knows.
What our panel thinks. John, you first.
Yeah, this is actually worth a lot more than that. This is, as I say, one of the top rarities of the 90s. £50 normally, plus, with all the signatures, I reckon anything up to 100 could be
fantastic. Yeah. Not that I'm selling it.
Absolutely.
What about this, Ted?
You might be a bit high. The nutty fan is just looking really basically for this.
Yeah.
I would say somewhere in the region of this time, with the nutty fan, about £30.
Not bad going.
Not bad going at all. Thanks for bringing it along.
No worries.
Well, that's all we've got time for this episode of The Vinyl Frontier. Thank you for all the guests for coming, and to also our guest panellists, John Reed and Ted Owen. See you next time, and we'll leave you with Blood on the Dance Floor.